okay, here we have my carbon arc lamp that's in rough shape that I'm slowly restoring in bits. This is a Thompson, and these lamps were used before incandescent lighting came around, so they were one of the first electric light sources. And all they are, this is a really big one, but they were just two carbon rods that touched together. When you put current to them, a magnet would separate them, and it would form an arc between them, just like an arc in a mercury vapor or metal halide lamp. In fact, the light they put out is very similar to an MH or a mercury vapor lamp, and it's a very bright purplish white light. And they were used mainly for street lighting and industrial indoor lighting, things like that. And they were made even when electric incandescent light came around. They still used them because incandescent bulbs couldn't put out enough light. And same thing today, where street lighting uses high pressure sodium, which puts out a lot more light than incandescent, and it's an arc light source. The arc lights were the high pressure sodiums of the late 1800s. They produce a lot of light, which an incandescent couldn't do, and they use relatively little power to do it. So the arc lamp was king up until, probably the 20s, actually. In England, they used them all the way up into the 1960s, even into the 70s. So arc lamps were with us for quite a while, actually, even though it was the first light source. These are some of the internal parts. This is the frame that goes down under here. And this is where your arc actually goes, your carbon rods. These are some of the windings from the coils inside that are actually shot. I'm gonna have to redo them. And this is the ballast, which piece of insulation material here. And this is the ballast, or the choke coil. And the wires are right down to bare copper, so it's gonna have to all be rewound. But basically, it's an HID light source, high intensity discharge. It's just, it does the arc in air instead of through a gas or a metallic vapor.